Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ShadowFury333, and, well, I looked around the chapel area and couldn't really find a lever. Might have missed something. I'll have to check. If someone knows if I missed a lever for that thing that Patch has dropped, please let me know. But for now, first off, I forgot one thing before. Story time with that doll. Or for that doll. Where's that doll? There's the doll. Silverwork doll depicting a young squire. In the legendary old city of Irithyll, situated in the Boreal Valley, the Pontiff Sullivan gave this doll to valued subjects, so that they might use it to cross the barrier when they return home. Listen carefully, and you can hear it say, "Wherever you go, the moon still sets in Irithyll. Wherever you may be, Irithyll is your home." Okay, let's go off to Irithyll. Steal this crap. So now I have the doll, I can just go in. We're going to Disneyland! Okay, I'll stop calling it that. I think I've called that often enough. Eh. Neat. Anyway. Bonfire on the other side. Alright, is there anything around here? Looks like no. Ooh, Rhine Blue Moss Clump. That's probably for Frostbite. I mean, I mentioned before, I'm guessing, yeah, Frostbite. Frost accumulates in the body, causing Frostbite, which saps one's health, lowers absorption, and slows stamina recovery. Weapons imbued with frost are a rare thing indeed, most of them originating in the Boreal Valley. So I'm gonna have to be wary of that. What's my current Frostbite resist? Eh, 185. Might change around armor if I have to, just in case. But for now, I'll stick to this. Place looks nice, though. Here, Titanite Lizards. I don't know where they are. Probably in a lower area of this. Nothing down here. Nope. What the... That's not a player. That looks like the Dancer of the Boreal Valley. I don't know what it's doing. Are you going somewhere useful? Nope, you're vanishing. Okay, never mind. Well, that was a bit of a waste. Moving on. Let's see where the next thing takes us. Oh. I see. Well, at least I can slash them up, but... Ow! Sheesh. Alright, that's gonna be annoying. So, speedy enemies, not really surprising. Oh, what's in here? Does not open from this side, as usual. Another fat priest in there, okay. And then one of these with a sword. Oh no. I mean, shield, not sword. Ugh, they all have swords. Ugh. Man, I hate trying to fight these type of things. They don't know how to fight them properly. Actually, I just remembered, I forgot an Esther Shard. I'll be back in a sec. Alright, we're back. This is probably going to be painful. Because this... I just find quick enemies like this really hard to deal with. Oh, small mercy. It appears they're not respawning. Ow! Small mercy. Darn, that hurts. Okay, heavy standard bolts are bust. Clearly it's not gonna work without them. Hey. It's like I mentioned before about the rolling system in this game does not suit enemies like this. I can't roll on reaction, but they're all about reaction. Don't know how else it's to fight them. Well, best hope I've got is staggering them out. We're gonna be here all day.
I hate this area already.
Okay, one down fairly easily at least. What are you carrying? Oh, Pontiff Knight, that's what you're called. Let's check this out then. Curved swords wielded by the Pontus Knights, frigid spears that linger in Irithyll. The large blade appears to be eaten away by insects, making it lightweight but also brittle. Skills Frostblade, you execute a large spinning motion to imbue blade with frost, and follow through with a strong attack that slashes with a giant blade made of frost. Eh. It's not my thing, but okay. And for one thing, I can't actually wield it. Aha! I recover faster than you! Pont of Night leggings, okay. What the heck are you doing? Are you pulling at your own head? Ow. I missed. Come on, get stabbed! Yeah, there we go. That I want to see. Alright, I think I started getting the hang of these. Starting to, being the operative word. Or phrase, rather. What's up here? Large tendon shard. Also, I got Pontiff Knight leggings, so I might as well look at them. Also, I got this. Randomly, when I was searching, I went to the bonfire. I got this Archdeacon stuff. Skirt worn by an Archdeacon of the Cathedral of the Deep, worn underneath holy garb. Of the Archdeacons of the Deep, one attended to Rosaria, Mother of Rebirth, whom he deemed a goddess. And then the Pontiff Knight leggings. Leggings of the Pontiff Knights, now harrowed spears of Irithyll. This blue-gray leggings, shrouded in a thinly cold air, is light and brittle. Although, actually, there's also a couple other Archdeacon stuff. Archdeacon's Holy Garb. Holy Garb worn by the Archdeacon of the Cathedral of the Deep. A sign of the Way of White's highest rank. Of the three Archdeacons of the Deep, one stood over Aldrich's casket with hope that he would return one day. And last one's the hat. White crown worn by an Archdeacon of the Cathedral of the Deep. Presented solely to delegates of the gods. Of the three Archdeacons of the Deep, one cast off his white crown and left the cathedral to stand by Aldrich. So it actually sounds like all three are represented in those three pieces of armor. It's noticed that most armor is the same between it, but that's an exception. Okay, those are cruel. There's candelabras up there that look like the Pontiff Knights. Also, Holy Frozen Alien Lois Mark II. Here's all the Disneyland jokes. I forgot to point that out. Anyone who's played Dark Souls 2's DLC? Yeah, this is Crown of the Ivory King Mark II. Obviously. I mean, it's snowy city area, but it's also little bits of snow. No blizzard stuff going on, though. Nothing like you have to talk to someone to unfreeze things to be able to get into places. Okay, you're probably trivial. Yes, you are. Budding Green Blossom. There must be a better version of Green Blossom. Let's see. Yeah, large temporary boost. Flowers of the green blossom are ethereal, blossoming only on the surface of chilled but not frozen water. That explains where they came from. And I think that was about it for new stuff. Picked up something else, but I don't think it was new in any way. Be wary of hole. That's just blood. Hey, this sucks. Crap, they spotted me. Ow. Ow. Ah, come on! Give me 2 seconds, will ya? At least I have no close range. Oh, yep! There we go. You're annoying. I hope you're not responding, but you probably are since everything responds in this game. At least these enemies are trivial. Hey, another claymore. Not that I need it, but I guess I get another one. In case you didn't get one by the dragon and the very, very beginning of the game, they give you one here. Oh, what? Oh no, not you again. Oh, and of course you're up at the top or something. Okay. Well, now you're just annoying me. Ow. You know what? No. Eat lightning! Oh. Come on, seriously, you don't eat lightning? Eat lightning! Shoot. Ow! The slam I can handle. Everything else is kind of not sure to do about. Ah, timed that wrong. Ah, this thing's annoying as hell. Finally got rid of this stupid thing. And I got an Estus use back. Kind of wish I used my Ash and Estus before I did that, but oh well. And yes, I know I can backstab things to get my FP back, which is super handy, but, you know, that's also kind of slow. Okay, what's up here? Could I have just run up here and started slashing at this thing? Because it looks like I could have. Large Titanite Shard, and look carefully. I don't see anything too unusual. There's no path down this area, the rooftops. Yeah, nothing too unusual here. Oh no. Well, if you want to come here, feel free, but apparently your pathfinding sucks. So you're not going to. Unless you are going to. I don't know. Are you going to? I'm gonna be your friend. Kept going. Hey. Okay. There's another type of Pontiff Knight. It's more slender Pontiff Knight. I don't know. looks like I can't stab it down, so probably not. Oh shit. Did they see me? At least got a twinkling. Before I died horribly. They don't seem to really care all that much. And I'm fine with that, because fighting through these are really annoying. Alright, I think that's where I came in. No, that's not where I came in. That's actually areas I haven't even explored yet. Alright, so they're turning away. I have a chance, I think. Yeah, alright. Playing that like a stealth mission, because I don't want to fight those things if I don't have to. We've seen that I have a hard time against them. This is just a thing. Ah. What side does things open from? Sheesh. Or do things open from? Another large titanite shard. Think I'm getting some hints here. If you haven't upgraded your weapons pretty high already, now is the time to do so. Alright. Oh no. Ah! I can't fight more than one of these at a time, game! I can barely fight one of these at a time. Certainly can't fight two. This is impossible! This area is impossible. How do I get through this? The only way to get through this is to stealth through it or possibly pick them off one at a time. There's no other way! Like, even dodging only works if I'm fighting one of them, not a ton of them. Well, three, but three's way too many. Now to fight through all these bastards again. Right, that's what that was. The shortcut that I really want to get to, but it'll take me forever to do. Man, going from the Cathedral to the Deep, where everything was, you know, fairly challenging, to this, where my only hope is to stagger these things out, hopefully, maybe, if I'm lucky. And even then, it only works if I'm fighting one at a time. I'm so screwed. Back here. And I think if I go along here, there might be something different that I haven't seen yet. Well, there's this. Large titanite shard. No path to a shortcut, sadly. Like, I don't know, maybe I'm expected to just run through those enemies and try to fight them two at a time. I kind of doubt it. Oh, really? Oh. Yeah, really. What's the point of this area, then? Unless it's something to have prep for DLC, that might be why. Oh, thank God, a bonfire! I was right to go this way. Hey, Henry.
Oh, I thought it might be you. Good to see you. I never managed to find Horace.
That's unfortunate.
But my duty must be done, even alone, as an unkindled Lord Seeker. For the children I knew, bless their souls. We all have our reasons, don't we? Please, take this. Recompense for my foolish request. And also a token of protection. May the flames guide your way.
Yes! Finally! I've been wanting this forever!
Ah, you. I would do well, Metherflip. I would do well.
Alright, what can I put in place? Oh, this actually makes it really tough. Wanted to play around with Pontiff's Left Eye plus Ring of the Evil Eye. I think in place of all, I mean, I like Aldrich's Sapphire, but I'm not using a lot of stuff that's really justifying it, so I'm going to do that. And then probably switch this off for something a little lighter. Yeah, what's the defense switch? Switching down to, is that the improved lightning defense, actually? Not that it really matters here, and better frost defense. Slightly better frost defense, anyway. All right, mirror gloves it is. And I am still able to fast roll. Awesome. Ooh, what's this? Oh, it's probably a key item. Let's see. No? Oh, this must be, maybe it's a covenant item? No, I don't see it in here. I don't, oh, it is, yeah. Blood drained shrunken ear, souvenir taken for subduing the guilty. The knights called the Blaze of the Dark Moon punish the guilt-soaked defenders of the gods and take this as proof of their conquest. The earless corpses of the guilty will be left behind as a warning to others, inspiring both fear and respect for the gods. Such is the eternal mandate of the Dark Sun. Alright. So, covenant item, because I guess Blaze of the Dark Moon are from around here. Where does this lead? Be wary of ghosts. Be wary of dark spirit. Be wary of ambush. Okay. Oh, they're invisible. Okay. That's a fair warning. Thank you, random messages. Fading soul. Oh, one of you guys. I figured you might be. All right, Homeward Bone and whatever's behind here, which is Undead Bone Shard. Yeah, more of these. Awesome. That's actually the easiest Undead Bone Shard I've ever found. Considering we had one that was like giant shooting down on me and another one that was, I think somewhere in the middle. Was it Smoldering Lake? I can't remember. Undead Bone Shards have typically been the hardest item for me to find, like to successfully take. So that's kind of a relief. And is this the shortcut to the beginning? Please tell me it is. Oh, it's a dog. Eh, whatever. I can deal with dogs. Oh, I can deal with dogs. Not necessarily dogs. Shit! Ugh. Should have switched to my long sword. Well, at least it's not hard to get there. Forgot I gotta switch to the long sword because that's the only one fast enough for the dogs. Yeah, no, Henry's no longer there. Alright, whatever. Oh, I see where it is. You can actually see the ghost. Oh, for crying out loud, where's my stamina? Okay. Go. I guess nobody gained much health, but you regained some. Why do I keep doing that? Darn it. I should know the second bolt's gonna miss. It's happened once. I should know. Just have to experiment. You know? I mean, if I just did it the first time, I'd be thinking, oh, I possibly not be exploring enough, so... See, that's how I'm supposed to do it. One bolt, and then slashes. Like that. More kukri. Oh, you're just a dog. Okay. I was expecting a ghost somewhere around here. And it looks like there are none. Okay. Apparently the one that was there dropped an item when I killed it. Blue bug pellet. That must be for increasing frost resist. Oh, magic damage. No, never mind. Magic absorption. Medicinal pellet made from crushed insects. The blue type temporarily boosts magic damage absorption. The Boreal Valley is infested with moon bugs, meaning ingredients are never far from hand for the Irithylian slaves who concoct this medicine. Okay. Also, why am I sorting the way I don't want to sort? Yes. Okay, good. Back to normal. Alright, torch required ahead. Right. Oh, that's pretty dark. That must have hurt. Oh wow, that's a lot of ghosts. Sheesh. Man, this reminds me of a little under area. I mean, this whole area is kind of reminding me of Yharnam as much as it's reminding me of Frozen Lamb Lois. Oh, hang on a sec. Why am I disparaging torches? I have a torch. There we go. Ah. Torch. Torch mode. Oh, wait, I can do it with these, I think, unless this is, unless this is dogs. Ow, what was that? I thought it'd be harmless. Well, effectively harmless. Ugh. Getting too careless. I'm getting too frustrated, that's the problem. I mean, until I found this bonfire, I was feeling really stuck, so yeah. Still pretty salty about that. Wait, what's the... Try turning around sometime. Ooh. Guessing that is all the dark... Okay, online play item. A roster of knights of the Dark Moon who have served since the age of the old royals. Used to discover the names of Dark Moon knights, an order of elite knights shrouded in shadows. Okay. Use. Oh, it's just a leaderboard. Okay. Looks like no one's found a way to hack the leaderboards, at least. That's good. There's no one with like 4,294,000,000 contribution or negative that contribution. It's usually a pretty clear sign of, oh wait, I don't have, I'm over the weight limit, shoot. I didn't think about that. It's mirror time, I suppose. My favorite fashion souls option is just the defense. Defense is not great. All right. I know there are enemies behind as well, so I gotta take care of those. And there are some standing enemies. And there's this blue bug pellet. Oh, come on. Take that, you and your daggers. What the? Okay, that was weird. What is hitting those things? Oh, okay, more ghosts. Can't even see them with a torch? Really? Alright, all the healing. Oh, what the heck? It's like these healing rings don't do anything. Okay, they do a bit. But it doesn't feel like they do a lot. Okay. The Aldrich ring seemed to actually do a fair amount for what it was doing. The Aldrich Sapphire. The rest of these feel rather underwhelming. Well. Let's see what's up here. Okay, I believe that's an area I have not explored yet, but I don't— Wow! Shoot! Ow! That's not what I wanted. I mean, you can see why a torch is useful in here, but at the same time, I almost feel like that happened because I had a torch, and it messed up my low-light vision. Alright, so let's try that again. On the beam. Oh, shriving stone. Did you die? All right, that's where I started, I think. Wait, was it? Maybe. But there were some beams over there as well that, I don't know, might make a difference. Wow, did I slash that thing out of the air? That's pretty badass. Oh. Very small drop, actually. Oh, that's not a mimic. It was askew, I thought it might be a mimic. It's not, it's a Yorshka's spear. That's gotta be special. Let's see, Yorshka's spear is... There. This treasure, gifted to the Yorshka Church, is enchanted by a soporific spell and was surreptitiously worshipped by Irithel slaves. As a weapon, it is part spear and part hammer. The former allows thrusting, and the latter allowing strikes. Skill, pacify. Raise the spear in prayer and temporarily wear down enemy FP with each strike. Okay, that doesn't sound good. Is there a ladder down here? Yeah, at this point I'm going to turn the torch up because I think I need it. Nope, no ladder. Just a fall. Okay, well, is there anything else I missed? Because I went to the ladder, but I didn't go everywhere else. Oh, you're a phantom. We aren't in the shaded woods. I know phantoms are not going to hurt me. Okay. Well, Oh. Ow. Jerk. I don't know. I feel like Aldrich's Sapphire was more useful. Like, the small amounts of FP translate to a lot of health compared to the small amounts of health, which are just small amounts of health. Ah. Like, I'm getting some health. Fighting crowds successfully gets me a lot of health. That's cool. But I don't seem to get a huge amount of health. What? You're not dead? Like, I'm gonna need to Estus here, which... I don't know. I kind of want to use the ring to avoid having to Estus. I said trying to avoid having to Estus. I want to avoid having to use Estus if I can possibly do so. But apparently not. Oh, Where'd my stamina go? There we go. Okay. You're dead at least. So there's a drop down here. I don't think so. No. Not now, anyway. Yes, there is. Oh, come on. Get back here. Give me more twinkling, because that seems to be all that Titanite lizards drop anymore. How much do I have? Not that I need it for anything, but like, how much do I have? 10. I can actually see how much the Urithel Straight Sword goes to, now that I think about it. I don't know how useful it'll be in an area full of frost enemies, but it's there. Can I move? No, I cannot move easily through this area. Well, let's grab the green blossom. I can see why it's here, I just don't really know how much I want to use it. I mean, it's obviously here because you have to roll through the water in order to get anywhere. And so to make that easier, to give you some green blossoms. Because it uses a lot of stamina, but yeah. Not happening. Okay. Actually, I didn't think about it. No, I don't have them in here. I had them in here for a while. So I was playing around, trying to see if they were useful. They weren't. Not noticeably anyway. Wait a sec. I've fought these things before, haven't I? Oh, no, I haven't. Yeesh. Those don't look pleasant. I fought that thing before. Not these weird leech-like monsters. What was the castle? Canehurst. Canehurst Castle. That's what they are. The Canehurst leeches. That's what they remind me of. Giant leech-like things in Canehurst Castle that... Yeah. Hey, I got great heal. Hooray! I can attune that, I think, instead of regular heal. Glorious miracle used by high-ranking clerics. Restores a large amount of HP for self and those in the vicinity. Only a select few have learned to recite this epic tale in its entirety, but those who do are amply rewarded. Oh, I can't use it yet. What's the requirement? Ah, 25. I mean, I'm gonna need to get Great Lightning Spear at some point too, and that requires 30 most likely, so I'm gonna probably get more faith. Like, my plan for stats is 40 endurance, 40 dexterity, 27 strength, because I think strength works like one, where if you two-hand, you effectively have 1.5 times strength, and the strength likely has a soft cap at 40. 30 faith, and then I think maybe 18 attunement and vigor as high as it can go. That won't give me above 120. Because I want to stick to levels between 90 and 120 for just in case for PvP kind of thing. Like, I don't know if I'm going to do much PvP. I have done a decent amount, but like dedicated PvP. I mentioned before, I don't really think that Dark Souls is the best PvP experience. Like, third-person action game PvP experience. There's a charm to it, mainly from the fact that you're basically playing a character you built. And there's a lot to be said for that. But I don't know, I guess I just feel like putting it above the standard PvP range is just over-leveling. Which is kind of ridiculous if you think about it, because that's really just a community standard thing of what is even leveled or over-leveled or anything. I don't know. More green blossoms. Lever ahead. Drop of death ahead. Actually, you know what? I've got something to say here, but I'll put it over... Although, maybe they've already said it. Did they already say it? Call that pointless? I call it gorgeous view ahead. That's what I call it. Alright, so... Looks like... Apparently there's a bonfire here, according to that message. I don't know if I trust it, but there is a path. Oh, there is a bonfire. They were right! That's good. Although, come to think of it, what's my Estus look like? Pretty... okay. Not ideal. Oh. Looks alright. Good enough. Alright, so... what's down here? Treasure ahead. Weird... oh, this is the same corpse thing I was fighting before. What are they running to? Alright, there's treasure. Oh, crap! There's this guy. Oh, would you just get hit? I'm dead. So why do these enemies exist in a game where you cannot dodge on the press of a button to dodge? Like, you cannot dodge on reaction, basically, in this game. Why did they design enemies around dodging on reaction? I don't get that. Oh, shit. Let me get my souls at least. Let me hit you! Let me hit you! Darg! So I need to use the wolf sword because the long sword doesn't stagger enough. The wolf sword does stagger enough. If I can get some hits in with a wolf sword, then I can kill it. Because I can stamina bar it to death. I can just full stamina bar kill. I'll let those enemies run away. Pick up my souls. And then kill you. There we go. And once again, full stamina bar, kill you guys too, and another claymore. I've got a lot of claymores to sell. And a blood gem. Oh! Crap. Alright. Can I backstab you? Come on, can I not backstab you? Oh, whatever, I can slash you with a little over a stamina bar, so whatever. That'll do, I suppose. Didn't provide that much more vision. This better be worth another large Titanite shard. I don't really think that was totally worth it. Whatever. At least I found a lot of stuff to explore that does not involve fighting a huge amount of those. Oh. Really? I would say why not, but I'm so close to leveling. Okay, I'll come back, level. I'll go, level, come back, and then see if there is a dark spirit, because maybe there's a dark spirit that's... maybe there are CB-controlled dark spirits. So far, I haven't found any. That doesn't mean there aren't any, I just haven't found them yet. Alright, we're back, and I leveled up Dexterity slightly, so my weapon damage is a touch higher. I can finally kill those ghost things in two swings of the Wolf Knight Greatsword rather than just one. And I also just got these gauntlets. What are they? Fire Witch Gauntlets. Gauntlets of witches who bore the profaned flame, now harrowed spirits of Irithyll. The witches who led the Pontiff Knights were originally ordained as holy knights. It was not long, however, before their hearts were swallowed by the profaned flame. My goodness, this is all just... this is all Ilium Lois. Like, Frozen Ilium Lois was basically this whole setup where you had a bunch of stuff to do with Bed of Chaos Flame. Eh, whatever. Which I think the Dark Gauntlets are going to be more suitable for my weight at this point. Yeah. Best defensive option by weight. So, I was wondering, was Ember... Oh, I got blood in my hair, that's why. Oh, okay, so there are some... Hey, you got the same style as me. Oh, same fighting style, I mean. Except so much more poise. Crap. Oh, come on, you didn't fall off? Seriously? Oh, come on, I thought I kicked you off! No, not normally. Immolation, what the heck is that? Immolation tinder. Oh. The halberd, profane flame wielded by the Erythlian witches, frigid spirits roaming the boreal valley. This torch, both a weapon and a staff, is enshrouded with an everlasting flame. Skill is punitive flame, which punish flows with a flame that blankets the ground. That sounds pretty good, actually. Don't have the intelligence for it, but that does sound pretty good. Alright, so if I'm gonna fight this thing, I'm gonna be fighting it with the longsword. Oh, where's my stamina? Now you fall off to your death! So what's Monokumo then? Oh, right, that was... different thing... where's... where's the sword? Oh, there it is. The curved sword of Alva, Seeker of the Spurn, specially forged in an eastern land. Sharp but heavy, the sword requires extreme strength and dexterity to wield. The search for the Spurn had no end, and so the Wayfaring Knight warmed to a most deformed weapon. But it skills the standard spin slash for cursed swords. Yeah, 20 strength, 18 dex. I could use it if I wanted to, but I don't. This. Pointless. If I drop down, I cannot get back up. So let's go through another path. Oh boy. Better heal up. Oh yeah, I also upgraded both the longsword and the Irithel straight sword. So the longsword, they're actually about even, but the Irithel straight sword is slightly worse, so I'm going to be using the longsword from now. If I can find a bit more twinkling, apparently twinkling works on 2 to the N, so it's 1, 2, 4, 8. Which is not quite as low as I thought, so I am going to need 4 more twinkling to even get that to +4. And if I do, then that will get me... oh, bonfire. That will get me to... slightly better position, I guess. Where I can basically just... what's down here? Okay. Thought there was an enemy about to kill me there. Oh no, that's not the enemy about trying to kill me. It's the rest of the dungeon denizens that are gonna try to kill me. Actually, I should probably end the episode pretty soon. Hey, that's the Tower of Latria gate opening animation. I haven't seen that in a while. How many? large titanite shards do I have? Ooh. One more and upgrade the crossbow, which I should have done in the first place since I kind of need that more, but that works. Well, didn't get a shot in, so I win. Thanks. Thank you for that. Okay, I think... Can I open this? I can open this! Good thing I got rid of the monster first. Be wary of left. Oh, is there another path going through here? Oh, nope. That's left. Oh, they take away your max health? Okay. That's worse than I expected. That better come back when I bonfire. Well, even then, that's still pretty bad. Oh, you have to wake people up, do you? Whatever, that's the large titanite shard I needed, and I think I will hack my way through a few zombies. Oh, good, my max health came back. Alright, that seems to be about all I care about right now. So, I will leave you all here in this horrible dungeon, because I'm a horrible person who leaves people in dungeons, apparently. So, thank you for watching, and stay tuned for the next one. Hopefully I'll be less salty that time, though, I don't know, this area...